You know, the word feminism is so strongly associated with, you know, strong women or women who are, you know, assertive and want to, array, oh, she's a feminist, you know, those kind of. So, I mean, is that really something so bad? And, you know, we're hearing so much these days about, I'm sure these things used to happen earlier on, but because of media also, so many, the Me Too movement, for example, do you think there is a need for such movements, or there is a need to kind of be assertive about these issues? Basically, does a woman, you know, learn to have to say no, both in terms in her professional life and also in her personal life? You know, because sometimes you may have a lot of personal pressures as well. You know, as you said, you're expected to fit into the good mother, good wife, good, you know, whatever image. And sometimes you need to say no to that also. So is that something, you know, you feel that that the tag of feminism is something that is, you know, attached to strong, assertive women?
So, you know.
Anyone, yes, please go ahead, yeah.
Thanks, Anuradha. So, you know, Pooja, I think feminism is an oft misused and misinterpreted word. If you really look at the definition, you know, feminism is basically the belief that men and women should have equal rights and opportunities. And I'm a strong advocate of equal access to opportunities, and irrespective of gender, race, color, ethnicity, sexual orientation. It's shocking in many ways that we're in the 21st century and, you know, equal access is something that, you know, even in terms of gender is something that we're still fighting for. And, you know, being a feminist just means that you're able to voice that out. And, you know, herein is linked the gender stereotype that women who voice things, you know, are too aggressive. They are looking for the easier way. The key is that we are looking for crafting that way, you know, and asking for a seat on the table. And, you know, when that table is of a particular gender, race or color, you know, that is something that needs to change. And I think that's what feminism is, you know, it's about equality, and painting it in any other color is not doing justice to the concept and the movement, and clearly it's important today, right? Just the kind of imbalance that we have, particularly at higher levels. I think entry levels, still progress has been made, maybe too little too late, but at least there is progress. And you know, just on Me Too, I think Me Too definitely was a seminal and a defining moment, because in more ways than one, the fact that women had to go public to seek redressal to harassment at the workplace, imagine what it would have taken, yeah. Right? For someone to bring that attention onto themselves and the burden that they were carrying to make their stories public, because the system would not address it in a systemic manner. That I think is something that is not solved or resolved today. And I think it requires far more conversation than what we've given it. So both those very important topics, and, you know, very keen to hear the thoughts of the other ladies over here as well on them.
Yeah, please. Anybody? Yeah, you can just go ahead. Yeah.
Well, Pooja, I'm a proud feminist, and I think everyone should be. I would... be very wary of a man who says he's not a feminist. What are we saying? Are you saying you do not afford the women around you equality? I'm actually beyond that. I'm an animal rights advocate. I'm talking about rights for animals. Just because they don't look like us, you know, why should they not enjoy the right to live peacefully? So I'm saying women's rights is, for me, it's almost like ridiculous to even be arguing for it today. I think we've passed that. It's now time to move on and look at other species who we trod upon every single day. People who know me will laugh, but that's where I am. So if you're talking about women's rights, honestly, you've missed the bus. This is now a foregone conclusion, but yet Yes, the fact is that it is, you know, like we say, the future is here. It's just not equally distributed. It's not visible to everyone. There are some people who, for whom this is not yet visible. For a lot of us, thankfully, today on the screen and people listening in, I think, you know, we've crossed that perhaps, hopefully in our personal, you know, in our worlds, we've crossed it. But yes, from time to time, to bring the rest of the world up to speed, you do need these movements. And even for us, movements like the Me Too movement, it's just an explosion of all the pent up, non-addressed issues around the table. I cannot tell you personally what turmoil it caused, because I have stories which are untold yet. And every time something like this comes up, I am like, I owe it to people to go public. I owe it to share, and, you know, Mansi said about talking, and I don't think women talk enough. I think we are the only ones who are suffering. There must be, you know, this is only happening to me. Doesn't happen to everyone else, be it performance at work, be it the pressure, be it the risk of failure, be it, hostile relations with colleagues or bosses, whatever it be. We just, you know, we go into a hole and we imagine that we alone are facing this, and we're the first person and the last person to face this. It's not true. And I think movements such as Me Too, and there are others, help us all realize we are not in it alone. Heard, talk about it, because you will help not just yourself, but you will help a wide swathe of population who are going through exactly the same thing, and will now find the courage and the voice to also, you know, collectively we can find a solution, because numbers do matter. And when we realize that, hey, you know, this is so widespread, A, it takes the guilt and the burden of carrying this alone, that gets lifted. But also we open the doors to dialogue and resolution. So more power to all such movements, whatever they be. I think it's a voice that enough people care, enough people feel the same way, that matters.
Yeah, great, great. Thanks thanks a lot, Mansi and Anuradha. Rashi, what's your take on this?
So I think feminism to me is the freedom to be. And I think that's not something that one has to fight for. It just has to be there. It's our birthright, just like it is for everybody else. And I think it's time for another Me Too. Now we may need to have another hashtag for that, because I think it's not only about sexual harassment at work. There is a lot of verbal harassment at work also, which goes unrecorded. Yeah. And that actually pierces you more. I'll give you an example without naming anybody or any organization. It was a lunch table conversation, and my boss says that, you know, if you are a double income family, you should be paying more taxes. So I didn't get it for a minute. And this is a good, great organization. And I was like, why? Because, you know, there are women out there who are doing household work, and there's a single earning member in the family, and he's paying taxes while you're getting earning for two people. And, you know, so you should be paying more taxes. Now, this is a very educated, senior person, business head. I didn't know what to do then. Now, what kind of a harassment is that? That's definitely not sexual harassment, but this is verbal harassment. You've got functional heads sitting on the same lunch table. Everybody's quiet except me, who's saying, what are you talking about? This is bullshit. Now imagine I have to go report to that same person post lunch. Yeah. I have to make a business presentation to him. And this is a thought I'm carrying in my mind about him. What is this? This is a Me Too of another kind. And these are the kind of stereotypes and mindsets that you are faced with at work, and how do you fight these? So, and that's what I'm saying, there needs to be another Me Too, another hashtag, which is going to, and now this may seem like a softer aspect, but this is
important. Yeah.
And I think it hurts the mindset and the psyche of the person who's hearing this, and it just gives more confidence to the person who's saying this, because there's nobody rising up. Imagine he or she could be carrying this same stereotype, the same thought in other organizations, and giving the same back to more people at the lunch table. And that's absolutely uncalled for. I think it's high time. And if it is our freedom to be what we are, you know, a homemaker, a professional, a baker, a journalist, whatever it is, and it is no one's business to judge us. Yeah. And for me, that's what is feminism is, and we should have no reason why we have to fight for it. It's our birthright, and that's what it is.
Right. Thanks, Rashi. Sujata, how about you? What are your thoughts on this?
Feminism is, I think, yes, we are past that. I think I've now been meeting people who call themselves feminists without a doubt in their eyes. Now, earlier, people used to think only females are feminist. It's very funny. But yes, now I see men openly accepting that, you know, I support this. And, you know, even Me Too is not just for female, it's for men too. So, you know, that acceptance has come in. And as Rashi said, these hashtags, I think, are very important because we all know some things are happening, but unless you put a header to it, you just don't know, okay, that's, you know, we can talk about it. You know, that's big, you know, everyone's going through that. So I think once you put that hashtag or a title to it, everyone just feels, I think it's just like a powerful movement that all of us are together and we are fighting all together. So movements like Women Support Women, you know, those movements are spoken about. And also the fact that, I'm just digressing a little bit, I feel, but the fact that when women say that, you know, women don't support each other, and that's something which is like, which has to go, and it's high time. And we have just, I think all of these we have crossed, but at some level, some people are still stuck. So these should be spoken about more so that the few of us just crossing it, we feel that, oh, we are over this. And, you know, we should not talk about it because everyone knows. But I think there are many cities or many organizations. For example, I was an organization in a steel industry where it was just very common to say that, oh, presentation has to be made beautiful, send it to Sujata, she'll make it beautiful. And it's like, I'm not working on that presentation, you know, I have something else to do. But just because the presentation has to look beautiful, don't send it to me. And it was just that's so demeaning. They don't realize, they feel that it's a good thing Sujata is doing, but the way it's said, requesting that, rather, do you have time to fix it, but then saying, oh, you'll just take 5 minutes, just make it beautiful. So these kind of thing need to just go away, and we should be able to talk about it and stand for it. I stood up for a lot of things, and people used to think that I'm just that time of the day, you know, that time of the month when she's just so aggressive. Oh my god, she's just being so serious about something which is not even so big. What have I said, you know, what is wrong in it? And when I stand up, and probably there are other girls who are also feeling that, and when I stood up, probably they also felt, okay, I can also say that, you know, that's important. We should always ask questions whenever we feel bad. I think we should just raise our voice, because there could be some, probably 10 more women who haven't said that. And we assuming that, you know, what everyone said, that I feel that it's only happening to me, that has to go. I think that way we'll be just making the entire world much better and aware about these things. In Suta, we have 80% female in the organization. We are a 100-member team. And the boardroom is 95% female. It was not conscious. It was not a conscious decision that I had to have female. But that role was suitable for that person. They came up and took it. And I'm just happy that the way we function, it's not about, we are not people dependent. We don't pass sexist remarks ever. I'm not saying because I am like this, but I feel that the women who have joined the organization are like that. So, yeah, I think we're just in the right direction, but we should never forget that I should not stop saying because I feel that, oh, everyone is aware. We just should constantly raise our voices whenever we feel that we are going, you know, things are going wrong, because it's not yet, we are not yet there. So,
And I think many women do not even realize that it's not okay to keep quiet. You know, they kind of internalize all this messaging, and they don't even realize that, you know, that they're actually accepting something that they should not be. Yes, agree with you. Yes, Swati, sorry, I think through the circle I keep coming to you in the last. Yes.
No worries. It's always good to really hear perspective of others, and it's really enriching so far. So Pooja, I so agree with what Anuradha ma'am said. I think I'm also one of the women who've moved past this whole concept of equal rights. I think it's time that we really feel and believe that equal rights are table stake, and actually move to asking the bigger things that we actually as women face almost daily in our lives.
I remember you shared that, you know, you were selling cigarettes when, you know, so that was like a male bastion you broke into. So what was
absolutely.
That like?
And enjoyed breaking into that bastion very much. I just complete my thought on feminism, Pooja ma'am. So I so agree with what, you know, Anuradha, Mansi, Rashi and Sujata spoke about. But, you know, in my experience of having worked selling cigarettes and also working in rural markets, I really truly believe that we as women who are part of this panel and also the circle of friends we, you know, interact with are really the privileged lot. Really the top maybe 0.5% of the women who are in the Indian society. And while I, being that privileged woman, have moved to that evolved thinking on feminism, which is really about, you know, for me, feminism is really about saying that, listen, men and women should have equal rights. That's table stakes. But at the same time, man and a woman are not the same. Which is saying, for me, I really believe that every woman is not the same. And therefore, you know, when people say that you are a feminist because you have a certain type, which is you are a woman who has decided to unmute herself, has decided to really vocalize what you think, really say no, really be her authentic self. That's also a stereotype that women, that, you know, men and society in large places on feminist women. But I also really believe that we as a privileged woman have a lot of responsibility to bring the change at the grassroots level. And it is when we speak, when Mansi speaks, Anuradha speaks, Rashi and Sujata speak those things that they are supposed to speak about and say no to things that they are supposed to say no to, or they feel like saying no to, that's when we start creating that whole domino effect, which hopefully will reach the grassroots level. I genuinely, while working in market, have seen how women are treated, especially in smaller villages of Rajasthan, Vijay villages of UP, Bihar, etc. And I really feel that, you know, we as that privileged set of women have a responsibility to also create that community which Anuradha spoke about. That community, which will be a strong community of strong women, that community which makes people feel that they are included in the set, they feel that they belong and they are heard. And I think more power to Me Too movements, more power to us women who really are not afraid of speaking their mind and who really, you know, can bring about the change at the grassroots level, which is how I see feminism. Personally, I've moved to a different dimension of saying, how can I be a better person who really believes that every woman is different? And every woman might not even feel like speaking her mind out. Every woman has different ways of, you know, resolving her internal issues. And maybe she hasn't gone out and spoken about Me Too, but maybe in her circle, or maybe her circle, which, you know, she's friend with me, she has spoken about it. And I have done something to make sure that she feels better. So that's my take on feminism, Pooja. And of course, when selling cigarettes, I was, I dearly remember, and I really respect my first guide, who really, you know, asked me to ride a bicycle on my own, take a pack of cigarettes and sell it out in the trade. And you know, it was really, really hard at first, because you would see, you know, the people who sell paan, even my salesman did not used to take me seriously, ki ma'am aayengi, and she probably would not have even, you know, a clue of what she sold and how much money she would have made for the organization. But I truly enjoyed it, really. I think it was the first time I started riding bicycle on my own also, and started selling cigarettes, learned how to make a great paan. And I really enjoyed doing that. And I had a lot of interaction with senior leadership at that point of time, who were really curious to know whether I really was in the right, you know, even right space, even, and, you know, whether I was fitting in and blending in well, and whether I was liking my role. But I did enjoy it. And I had a lot of biases which were there in the start, which I had to overcome. But I think generally, if you work well, if you really take interest in something, then people notice you. And I genuinely enjoyed selling cigarettes, selling biscuits, selling even now in HUL, when anybody asks me, what do you essentially do? I still tell them, ki bhai, I'm a Marwadi girl selling, you know, tel, sabun to, you know, small outlets across Delhi. But I do enjoy that.